until Thursday, but the next instalment in the Captain America movie franchise has already been called Marvel's best film ever and the cinematic superhero showdown that you've been waiting for. The hunky Chris Evans returns to save the world in Captain America Civil War, and Angela Bishop caught up with Chris over the weekend for yet another morning TV exclusive.
Captain, while a great many people see you as a hero, there are some who'd prefer the word vigilante. You've operated with unlimited power and no supervision. That's something the world can no longer tolerate.
According to the comic book lore, Captain America is the greatest soldier of all time. In Australia, as we speak, we're marking Anzac Day, which is when we thank all of our soldiers for the sacrifices they've made. What qualities of a great soldier do you think Captain America has and embodies?
I think he's selfless. I think he's brave. I think he's honest. He's trying to fight for the common good.
This doesn't have to end in a fight, Tony.
You just started a war.
Were you at all concerned when you saw that Batman versus Superman was also going to be involving a fight between superheroes, to some extent over collateral damage?
No, not really. I mean, we were aware of that pretty early on, but I mean, it's surprising how many films can actually have similar plots on the surface but still be wildly different within substance. So no, we weren't too concerned. Just like
fire. How important are the audiences in this part of the world for these films?
Storytelling is as old in China as it is anywhere in the world.
Yeah.
It's a cultural tradition there. Mm. And I think cinema is an extension of their mythology and their folk tales. And these characters are mythological characters.
When you have something that's of quality and of this caliber that I think this movie is, it's exciting to try and share with as many people as you can.
I'm not the one that needs to watch their back.
This genre is ubiquitous right now. It's very saturated. And I think we're all just deconstructing at the same time. But ultimately, I don't think the movies are very similar.
AR-15s.
I make 7 hostiles.
I make 5.
What do you think fans will love most about seeing you guys going at it?
The fact that everyone you can relate to and you can understand why they're choosing the side that they're choosing. And it's gonna be really hard for fans to make the right choice. What is the right or wrong? There's no right or wrong. Both sides are right.
And yeah.
Stay out of this one. Please, you only make this worse.
It's a complicated world we live in. Mm. And I think, you know, when people go to the theater, it's great to give them entertainment and it's great to give them food for thought. If you can do both together, then that's a win-win for everybody.
You know what's about to happen. Punch your way out of this.
And so how was the decision made to split up the Avengers on who went on whose team?
It was a cocktail of reasons, you know. Some of it had to do with old ties, you know. Clearly you're gonna have Rhodey go with Iron Man. Clearly you're gonna have Falcon and Winter Soldier go with me. And outside of that, you know, they looked to the comic books at times, and then more than anything else, I think it was what best served the story. How do you kind of make this arc the most layered and conflicted?
Sorry, Tony. You know I wouldn't do this if I had any other choice. But he's my friend. So was I.
And you get a couple of the newbies, too.
Yeah, newbie. I guess Ant-Man is a newbie in the movie, but he's not a newbie to the universe.
No,
I think Team Iron Man gets the real newbies with Black Panther and Spider-Man.
On to ruse!
Hey, everyone.
Australians are pretty fond of you a lot, too. You do know we're not far away. You could have just...
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, was it 6 hours, right?
Yeah.
5, 6 hours, yeah.
Yeah, not much. You sure you don't want to hop on my plane?
No, Australia's on punishment for another year because you guys threw my friend off the opera house and almost killed him.
Your friend...
That's right. Hugh.
Hugh Jackman.
You threw him off the opera house.
I was there. He jumped.
No.
Sorry.
No.
Nobody pushed him. Nobody pushes the Wolverine.
You can't throw Hugh off an opera house and expect me to be okay with it. No.
I'm so confused. Christ, I'm so confused. So two good guys are fighting. Who do you side with?
Captain America and Iron Man. Well, that's the thing. It's like Batman versus Superman. They're both good, but they're both a bit bad. But they're
complex issues.
But yeah, it's complicated. If it was on Facebook, the status would be it's complicated.